Hi, welcome to Hall to my data science class. In this video, I am going to explain about the practical example of data cleaning. The data cleaning is used to remove the dirty data or noisy information that is present in the data set. For the today laboratory session, the question which is given is load the loan data set to the data frame. Use pandas methods such as head, info, and describe, and data frame attribute like column and save to explore it. Perform the following data cleaning operation for the above data set. For the today laboratory session, we are going to use the loan.csv file. The loan.csv file, this is the loan.csv file. This loan.csv file contains we are having loan applicant information. The first column is UID. The UID it indicates the loan applicant unique ID. The next one is marital status, whether marital status it is a categorical column. We will be having the value in the form of yes or no. The next dependent, how many dependent it is there, it may be 0 or it may be 1. Then is graduate, the is graduate also it is categorical value, we'll be having the value in the form of graduate or not graduate. Like that we are having 13 column. This is the loan.csv file. This csv file contains the noisy information. This noisy information we have to apply the data cleaning operation. Using the data cleaning operation we have to remove that noisy information and we have to make our data set as a good. That is our today laboratory session objective. The first what we have to do now, the first thing is you have to load the data set. If you want to load the data set and if you want to do the data cleaning operation, there are two packages it is important. The first one is pandas, the second one is numpy. That is why you have to import this pandas as a pd, the numpy as a np. These two packages it is important to perform the data cleaning operation. I have imported. The next, using the read.csv, you have to load this loan.csv file. That should be assigned to df data frame. When this line is executed, the loan.csv file is loaded to this df data frame. The df is a data frame. The data frame contains the value in the form of a tabular format, in the sense row and column. Now the df save is a attribute. If that line is executed, what will happen? It will print the number of row and number of column that is present in the loan.csv file, or else in the sense the df data frame. The df data frame is contained the content that is present in the loan.csv file. Now I am going to run this program and I am going to show the output. Now you see, when this code is executed, the loan.csv is loaded to df data frame. The df.save is a, it is an attribute. If this attribute is executed, it is printing the number of row. According to our case, the number of row is 615. The 615 row that is present in the loan.csv file, then 13 column that is present in your loan.csv file. The next, I am going to execute this info method. When you are executing this info method, it will display the information, the general information about your data set. What is the column? What is the column name? What is the total number of column, total number of entries, everything it will display. Then as well as it will display what are the data types of your column. Then what is the memory usage of your data frame, everything it will display. The info is a method. Using the method, we can display the basic information of the data set. Now you see, when it is executed, it is printing the range index, in the sense 615 entry that is present in the df data frame. Then the index will start from 0 to 614. Then the data column, we are having 13 column. Then we are having the first column is UID. We are having 615 entry that is present. This data type is object. Then we are having marital status. We are having 613 entry. In the sense that two value it is missing. The data type is object. Then suppose if you look at the another column, no, the loan amount is a column. We are having 592 entry, it is present. The other entry, it is a missing entry. Then you see the data type is float. Now the finally, if you look at, no, the memory usage of the df data frame is it took 62.5 KB. Now I am going to execute this describe method. Using this describe method, it will display the descriptive statistics of the df data frame. It will display count, min, max, standard deviation, mean, all the descriptive summary of the DF data frame is displayed here. Actually, this is also important when you wanted to perform the data cleaning operation. Okay, the latter, when you applying the outlier, I will show you why do you want to use this descriptive statistics. Then I am going to run this head method. Using the head method, I am going to see the top 5 entry that is present in the DF data frame. Let's see, I am going to run. You see, when this head method is executed, it will display the top 5 entry that is present in the DF data frame. The first column is UID, marital status, dependent, is graduate, income, loan amount, term month, credit score, like that, all the column, first 5 entry, it is printed. The first I am going to explain about the trapping duplicate. The trapping duplicate is the first data cleaning operation. If you want to use this trapping duplicate, we have to use your data frame name. According to our case, the data frame name is df.trapDuplicate. The trap duplicate is a method. Using the method, we can remove the duplicate row that is present in your data set. Let us consider our data frame. The DF is our data frame. It contains the row 0 and row 1. It is a duplicate row. For example, in row 0 also 2, here also no, in dependent also 0, in the sense all the column of row 0 and row 1, it is same. The row 0 and row 1, it is a common value, is present in all the column, not only in the UID, all the column it is present, the common value, it is a duplicate row. This duplicate row, it should be removed. The part that you can invoke this trap duplicate method. Using the trap duplicate method, you can remove the duplicate row and you can keep the first row as it is. Now you see, when I'm going to run this code, what will happen? It will keep the first entry as it is. It will remove the column number 1. It will keep the 0th row as it is, and it will remove the row 1. Now I'm going to run this head method. Now you see the 0th row, it is present as it is, but the row number 1, it is not there. The reason is the trap duplicate is a method. When this method is executed, what will happen? It will remove the duplicate row that is present in your data frame. That is why the duplicate row is the first row, that is a duplicate row that is removed. Now I am going to explain about this is the row level duplicate removal. The next I am going to explain about column level duplicate. For example, if you want to do the column level duplicate elimination, in the trap duplicate method, you have to pass for which column you want to apply trap duplicate. According to my case, for UID, I want to apply trap duplicate. Okay, then I am in the keyword parameter, I am passing the first as a parameter. It means that whenever the duplicate value it is coming, the first you have to keep as it is, the remaining value only you have to delete. Okay, the trap duplicate is a method. Using that method, we can perform the column level duplication also. In this case, I am going to give the UID as a column level input. I am going to give as a first. In the sense, the first value, it will be kept as it is. The remaining duplicate value, it will be deleted. Now, I am going to run this code and I am going to show the output. When I am running this code, now you see the previously the data, the number of row that is present in this data frame is 614. Now the number of row that is present in the data frame is 612. It means that there are two columns. It is a duplicate column that is removed. Now the number of entries that is present in the data frame is 612. The next I am going to explain about data standardization. The data standardization, in the sense, for example, let us assume I am going to consider this marital status column. Using this value count method, I am printing the marital status, in the sense whether they are married or not. It is stored in the form of yes or no. Now you see, in this marital status column, this yes or no is stored in the two different format. The first one is it is stored in the both combination of lowercase letter as well as the uppercase letter. It is stored in the form of uppercase letter as well as lowercase letter. In the second S, it is stored only in the form of uppercase letter. That is why we are having the four different categorical value. Okay, this should be converted into two categorical value. The for that we have to use the data standardization cleaning operation. Using the data standardization cleaning operation, we have to convert into a standard format. The for that, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to extract this marital status column. In the marital status column, I'm going to invoke this str.upper. The str.upper is a method. Using that method, we can convert whatever the content that is present in this marital status column that is converted into uppercase. Again, that is assigned to this marital status column. Again, using this value count method, again, I'm going to print the marital status column value count. When I'm printing now we will be getting only two column, yes or no. Now if you see this yes and this yes, it is combined and it is assigned into only one column yes. Then this no and this no also it is combined. You are having 225 entry. Now actually like this you need to standardize. Actually this is very very important. If you are not standardizing, without standardizing, if you are doing the data analytic process, here you will be getting confusion. Okay, that is why this need to be converted into same format and you need to use. Again, for this the sixth column also I am going to print the count. Now you see when the user is entered, the sum user they have entered as a male, the sum user they have entered as a young, the sum user they have entered as a female, sum user they have entered as a F. That is why we are having the four different categorical value. This also it need to be converted into two categorical value. According to my case, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to convert this all this, I'm going to change this M as a male, the F as a female. The for that, what I'm going to do now, I am extracting the df.sex column. In the sex column, I'm going to apply the replace method. In the replace method, I have passed the dictionary as a parameter. In the dictionary, the M it takes the key, the corresponding value is male. The F it takes as a key, the corresponding value is female. Wherever in my sex column, the M is coming, that should be replaced by male. Then the wherever my dictionary, the F is coming, that should be replaced by female. When this line is executed, what will happen? In the df sex column, the M should be replaced by male, the F should be replaced by female. Then if I'm trying to print this value count, only we will be having male and female. We will not have this M and F. Now you see we are having male and female. We are not having M and F. Okay, this is how we can standardize the data and we can convert it into same format. Even if your data, if it is in some other column, if it is in different format, it need to be converted into common format. Then only we can apply the data analytic algorithm to process our data. The next I am going to explain about handling incorrect data. Suppose if you wanted to handling the incorrect data, for that I am going to describe my data set. When I am describing my data set, you see in the age column, the minimum age is minus 20. This is the incorrect data. This incorrect data, it need to be handled. In the sense, this is not a correct value. This correct value, what you have to do now? We have to find out this correct value. This correct value, it should be removed with the corresponding correct value. This is the incorrect data. The reason is the age, it will not come in the form of negative value. That is why this age should be removed. The corresponding value should be inserted. The for that I have written this for loop. Using this for loop, what we can know now, if any age column, if it is any negative value is there, that negative value should be replaced by the value 20. The for that what I am going to do now, in the range function I am going to give the df.shape. The df.shape of 0 contain the number of row that is present in our data set. According to our case, the number of row is 612. This for loop, it start from 0 to 612, it will generate the sequence. Okay, it will iterate one by one, but the iloc method, the first it will take 0 and it will check in the 0th location. in the age column, in the 0th location, it will take that value. It will take the value and it will check. If it is less than 1, if it is less than 1, what you have to do? You have to insert 20. It means that if your age column contains the negative value, what you have to do? You have to change that negative value as a 20. If it is not less than 1, there is no need to update. The objective of this for loop is, what we are doing, we are checking the age column one by one. If the age column value is negative value, we are changing it as a 20. If it is greater than, we are not going to do any other work. Now, when this for loop is executed, no, it will check all the negative value that is present in the age column that is changed as a 20. Now, I'm going to run this describe method. When I am running this describe method, I have applied this describe method only to the age column. Now you see, in the age column, again it is coming minus 20. It means that this code is not executed properly. Again, I have to run one more time. Again, I have to run this code. When I am running, now you see this age column, it is updated. Now if you look at in the age column, the minimum age is 20. The previously in the age column, the minimum age is minus 12. Okay, the previously the minimum age is minus 12. Now it is changed into minus 20. Okay, this is how you can handle the incorrect record. The next we will discuss about how to handle the missing value. If your data set contains the missing value it should be removed. If you wanted to understand how many missing value that is present in your data set, we have to use isNull. The isNull is your method. This method, it will check your data set. If your data set contain is a null value, it will return true. If your data set contain not null, it will return false. The next, for this df data frame, for all the column, this isNull is your method, it is executed. How many null value is present, for that it will return true. For example, in the df data frame, the loan UID, 10 null values there means automatically it will return 10 true. Then using the sum method, it will sum up this true value and it will print. The first I am going to run this code and I am going to show the output. Now you see, now the UID column, we are not having any null value, that is why it is printing 0. In the marital status, we are having 2 null, that is why it is printing 2. In the dependent column, we are having 50 null value, it is printing 15. Using this is null, we will check whether the data frame contains null or not null. If it is null, it will return true. Using the sum function, we are summing up all that null for the corresponding column and we are printing it. The next, for the is graduate column, I am going to apply the value count method. If you check now, we are having 477. There are two categories. The first category is graduate. In the graduate category, we are having 477. In the not graduate, we are having 134. Now, the fill na is a method. The fill na is a method. That is used to, we can fill the null value. In my case, df loan amount mean. Okay, now the df loan amount mean is a method. Using the mean method, I'm going to compute the mean for this loan column. Okay, wherever in my data frame df, the loan column, it is null value is there. No, there I have to insert this mean value. That is why here I have given this keyword parameter in place equal to true. It means that wherever in my data frame df, the loan column, that null value is present, no, for that I need to compute this mean of the loan amount, that should be inserted. Again, for the term months also the same process. Wherever in the term month column the null value is there, it should be filled as a mean of the term month. Okay, then again in the age column also, wherever it is the null value is there, what we have to do? We have to compute the age column mean, that should be inserted into this age column. The next, if it is continuous variable, we can compute the mean value. The mean value should be inserted into null column. If it is a categorical value, the further what we have to do? If it is a categorical value, using the value count, we have to understand for the which category it is having the highest category. For example, in our example, for the graduate category, it is the highest category. In the sense, the 477. That is why what I am going to do now. In the is graduate, I am going to fill null. I'm going to fill as a graduate. The reason is the graduate category only we are having highest entry. That's why I'm going to here, I'm going to fill it as a graduate. Then draft NA is a method. It is used to, we can delete the missing value in the remaining variable. The missing value that is present in the remaining column. Then after that, I'm going to invoke df.isNull sum method. When I am invoking now, it will display the remaining null value that is present in the data set. Now you see that we have removed all null value that is present in the data set by using this df.draftNA method. The next I am going to explain about the converting data types. The converting data types in the sense, for example, the string data type can be converted into int, the int data type can be converted into string, then as well as the object data type can be converted into int. For example, if you want to understand what are the data type that is assigned to your column value, you have to use the df.info method that which we have discussed earlier. Now you see the UID is a column, the data type is object. The marital status is a column, the data type is object. Then you see the age is a column, the data type is float. Then as well as the sex is a column, the data type is object. Then you see actually in the marital status, especially in the marital status, the marital status is a column, it is an object data type. Actually, the marital status is not an object type, it is a categorical type. We are having only two values, yes or no. That is why this object data type, it need to be converted into categorical data type. The for that, we can use this as type method. The as type is a method that is applied to the marital status column. Okay, that marital status column, the previously it is in the form of object data type that is converted into categorical data type. That is why in the as type method, I have passed the parameter as a category. When this line is executed, what will happen? This marital status column, it is converted into categorical data type that is assigned to, again, the marital status column. The next, what I am going to do now, the sex also column, it is in the form of object. That also it need to be converted into categorical data type. For that, again I'm invoking this as type method to the sex column. I'm passing the parameter as a category. When this method is executed, what will happen? It will convert this sex column into categorical type. It is assigned to sex column. Again, for the is graduate column also, I'm applying as type method. Using that method, I'm converting this as graduate column, the previously in the object, that is I'm converting into object that is assigned to is graduate column. Then you see the income column. The income column, it is in int. I want to convert that income column into float. In df.income as type, in the method as type method, I am passing a parameter as a float. It means that this income column previously in the integer, now it is converted into float, that is again it is assigned to income column. Then after that, I am going to run this code and I am going to show the output. Now you see the sex column, now it is in category. The previously it is in the form of, the sex column is in the form of object, as well as is graduate also it is in the form of object. Now if you look at, the is graduate is a column, it is in the form of categorical data. Then as well as the income column, now it is in the float data type. The previously it is in the integer data type. One of the advantage of converting the data type, one data type into another data type, is we can reduce the memory size. For example, the previously the memory size is 58.5 KB. Now the memory size of the data frame is 47. The reason is the object data type would take the huge amount of memory, whereas the categorical data type, it will take the less amount of memory. That is why if any variable, if it is storing the categorical value, but if the data type is in object data type, that need to be converted into categorical data type so that we can save the memory usage. The next I am going to explain about outlier treatment or outlier removal. The outlier means that is an unusual pattern that is present in the data set. For example, for the income column, I am going to check whether there is any outlier or not. For the first, I'm going to invoke this Q method as well as the describe method. Using that method, I'm going to understand the descriptive statistics of the income column. Now you see, using the skew method, I have printed the skewness of the income column. Here the values, it is in the form of 23. The 23, it is not correct value. If your data set does not contain any outlier, means your skew value, it should be between minus 1 to 1. If your skew value is, if it is in between minus 1 to 1, means your data set does not contain any outlier. If it is greater than 1, it means that your data set contains the outliers. The outlier should be removed. The outlier, in the sense, it is unusual pattern that is present in your data. That unusual pattern you need to find out, that need to be removed. If you wanted to understand any outlier that is present in your data set, you can apply this skew method. Using this skew method, you can print the skewness. If the skewness is, if it is greater than 1, or else if it is the value should be between minus 1 to 1. If it is greater than 1, it means that the data set contains outlier. That need to be removed. Then again, for the income column, I am going to generate the 10th quartile of 10th quartile as well as the 90th quartile of the standard deviation I have generated. Here, not standard deviation, I have generated the mean. When I generated the mean, now I am getting 9124 for the 10th quartile. For the 90th quartile, the mean of the income is this one. I am going to use this value. With the help of the value only, I am going to remove. It means that the value that is less than this range, I am going to remove. The value that is greater than this range, I am going to remove. The for that, I am going to use this npVar method. In the npVar method, you have to apply the income less than this range. And here I am checking this condition. If the condition is true, you have to take this value. The value should be assigned to the income column, to this income column. Suppose if the condition is false, what you have to do? You have to take the value that is present in the income column, that should be assigned. The npVar is a method. In the var method, we are passing some condition. The condition is, we are extracting the income and we are checking with the maximum value. If it is greater than, then what you have to do? You have to take this value and you have to assign. If the condition is false, you have to take what is the content that is present in this income, that should be assigned to your income column. Actually, using this two line of code, what I am going to do now, I am checking the minimum range as well as the maximum range. If it is present the minimum range, that should be removed, that should be assigned to this minimum range value. Then if any value that is goes out of this range, that should be removed, that should be assigned to this value. Now again, I'm going to apply this skewness function. Using this skewness function, I'm going to print what is the skewness of my income column. Now you see, now the skewness is 098. Okay, it is good. Now again, I'm going to invoke this describe method. Using the describe method, I'm going to display this descriptive statistics of my DF data frame. Now if you see my salary details, especially in the income here, if you observe, no, the maximum range, it is above, it is in the range of 45,000. If you previously, if you look at this maximum range, no, it is in the form of 10 crore. Okay, this is the unusual pattern that is present in our data set that need to be removed. The part that only we have applied this outlier removal code. Using the outlier removal code, we have removed the unusual pattern that is present in our data set. The next one is trapping irrelevant column. The trapping irrelevant column, in the sense, some column that may not be needed for our data science application, that is irrelevant for future. For example, in our loan.csv file, the hobby is a column. That column, it is not at all required for the loan application. Okay, that is what I'm going to do now. I'm going to remove that column. If you want to remove that column, you can invoke the trap method. In the trap method, for which column you wanted to remove, no, that column you need to specify. Now, the next in the axis parameter, you need to specify one. The one, it indicate column. Suppose if you are giving the zero it indicate that is row level removal. If you are giving the one, it means it is column level removal. Now I am going to run this code and I am going to show. Now you see the SavePC method, when the SavePC attribute, when this attribute is printed, now it is printed 12. The previously the number of column that is present in this data frame is 13. Now the hobby is a column, the column is removed. Now the number of column that is present in the data frame is 12. Okay, now the objective of this laboratory session is how we can perform data cleaning operation. Okay, thanks for watching. We will meet in the next laboratory session class.